Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cube, and in this video, I'm going to share with you some updated info for Power BI Premium Gen 2 that you should know about. Let's do this. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. Full disclaimer, I am recording this video as of January 2022. I did some previous Power BI Premium videos, one on just Premium Gen 2 and another on the actual metrics app itself. And since then, there's some updates that I wanted to give you. As always, be sure to check out the documentation for the latest information to stay up to date. All right, the first thing I want to call out is the documentation for the transition plan to Power BI Premium Gen 2. If you're still on Gen 1 for Power BI Premium, the date kind of changed of when the migration is going to start. Before, it called out January 15th, but that has since changed to March 2022. So you still have some time to figure out what's going on. Make sure you're testing your capacities. Get them over to Gen 2 as soon as you can so that you can figure out, hey, is everything going smoothly? Make sure there's no problems. Of note, admins, you should be seeing some communication going out soon, giving you heads up that this is coming. But if you're watching this video, you already know. Another doc update I want to call out is updates to the actual installation and usage of the Gen 2 metrics app. So this has been updated to reflect the latest updates that I called out in the video in December, going through that updated metrics app that shows you how to figure out overloaded, the point in time, all of that great stuff. So it is now updated officially. So definitely go check that out as well. There's also an issue that I was made aware of for the Gen 2 metrics app that is kind of random. So some people may see this, but it's probably not a big deal. I just want you to be aware of this. So let's head over to my desktop and take a look at this. I am inside of the Gen 2 metrics app. What I want to call out your attention to is this visual here. I called this out in the last video saying like this kind of gives you that information to know if you're overloading. So part of this visual is there is a line here, which is your limit. That limit here is 120. I'm on a P1. And if we look at the Y axis for CPU seconds, it's around 120. That looks right to me. And we can see that we're clearly going and overloading. And then this is also reflected in the overloaded minutes per hour. What I want you to pay attention to are the little lines here that are clearly under the line. There is a potential here that you may see that the secondary Y axis for the limit is displayed. By default, it should not be displayed. So in this case, my view is correct. This looks right. Everything lines up. We're good to go. But let me go in and we'll edit this visual. There's an option here to show secondary. I'm going to turn that on. What we'll see here is that now this limit line is showing around 200 for me. In the case that I had that was brought up to me by one of the members here on Guy in a Cube, they were on a P1 as well. And so their limit was 120, but they were showing around 50 CPU seconds and it was over that limit line, which was not correct. And so it kind of was misleading. Of note, I'm still having conversations on that. I don't know if that was what was misleading or if there was something else, but this is definitely not correct. If you do see this, you've got two options. One is you can try just ditching this and reinstalling the app and just see if that fixes it. The other thing is you can come in and edit the report and just make sure that show secondary is turned off. If it is showing off and you're seeing the y-axis, just toggle it like twice and see if that corrects it. From what I understand, this hasn't been able to be reproed in-house. It's hard to debug this if we can't reproduce it. So in the case that was brought up to me, they were saying, look, this thing's showing I'm over that limit line, but nothing else is actually showing overloaded minutes at all. Clearly it's misleading. Like, why is this happening? At least from what I understand, it could be because that secondary axis is showing and that's causing the graph to not be aligned correctly. So the other thing I want to call out to you is if you move a workspace from one capacity to another capacity, be aware that the data set itself for the metrics app will need to be refreshed to account for that move. In my last video, I mentioned that there are two aspects to this. There's imported data for this report, and then the actual metrics information is direct query. So what's being imported is the metadata. So the capacity names and the artifact names, like the workspace, the data set name. And so if you move a workspace from one capacity to another capacity, the metadata that's imported now is stale and needs to be refreshed. You can just wait for that data to refresh. It refreshes daily, so it should be okay. The other thing is you can just go force a refresh on the metadata. After you do the move itself, maybe wait, I don't know, 5-10 minutes just to make sure everything goes through correctly, and then refresh that data set to make sure that the metadata is correct in the report. So if you see an oddity there and you just moved a workspace, just be aware that that could happen. All right, so just a few updates just to keep you going on what's going on with Power BI Premium Gen 2. 2. Hopefully this helped you. Let me know in the comments below if you thought this was interesting. Did you run into any of these? Are there other items that you're running into? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button. Smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.